Hi, Angela from Eurender here. In this video, I will show you how you can quickly create an abstract flower with subsurface scattering using Eurender in Cinema 4D. I have my scene already prepared. Just take one of our lighting presets for the overall lighting and select an HDR image that you like. I will link the presets in the description below. First, let me show you what we're gonna create. I used the dark gray as background color for better demonstration purposes. Now go over here and create the landscape object. Position it wherever you like. The first thing you're gonna do is set it to spherical. Now you have this landscape sphere. And for more details, just bring up the value of the width segments to around 800. I'm gonna decrease the size of it, especially in the x-axis. Turn off the multi-fractal. You can play around with the settings to get many different results. I will show you some at the end of the video. Next step is simply twisting the landscape object we just created. Click on your object and with Shift selected, select Twist. I'll bring up the value of the angle to about maybe 390 degrees. I'm gonna mirror it, so set it to minus 390 degrees. Change the size, rotation, position of the twist object to your liking. And I'm just gonna increase the twist size a little bit. So now that we have our desired shape, we can move on and make a cool material with subsurface scattering. Make sure that your lights have shadows enabled for subsurface scattering to work. The lights of our lighting presets already have shadows enabled. Create your Eurender material and assign it to your object. I will start with the color first, but I'm gonna turn on subsurface and enable the translucency. Back to the color, set a gradient as your texture. I'm gonna make a pink bluish to white gradient. You can achieve different kinds of gradient looks just by using another type. Lower the mix strength and set a color. Go to reflectance and increase the brightness and glossiness a little bit. I'm gonna change the specular color to a light blue. Back to subsurface. I always start with the translucency first and then use the surface scattering to smooth everything out. I'll increase the strength and adjust the wrap lighting. Now enable surface scattering and smooth everything out by increasing the strength, depth falloff, and sample count. Do some color correction and use curves to make the colors pop. For the animation, I only animated the sea level of the landscape object like this. That's it. Hope you liked this video. Be creative and create your own abstract scenes. I like this technique since you can easily create random forms and pretty backgrounds. Thanks for watching.